Yo, what if you could take the power of DAX and make it truly your own? Today, we're gonna dive into one of the most exciting features in Power BI, User Defined Functions, or UDFs for short. These little game changers let you simplify complex logic, reuse those calculations, and unlock cleaner, smarter models. Whether you're building dashboards for your team or scaling enterprise reports, mastering DAX functions will take your analytics to the next level. Let's break it down and see how you can start using them right now. So, you know what we like to do? Enough of all that talking, let's head over to my laptop. Here in Power BI Desktop, if you want to create user-defined functions, you need to enable the preview feature. You can choose a little gear and choose preview features and scroll to the bottom. You'll see user-defined functions. Check it and click OK. You may have to restart Power BI Desktop. And I was at a conference and someone wanted to create like these top measures. And so I want to see the top customer. In my semantic model, I want to see the top five products. It's just concatenated lists that return the top. If I want to see the top three territories, that's all it is. And we chatted about it. There's actually a quick measure in here that will build this up for you. So I showed them that quick measure and they went and started creating all these different measures. And at that point, I started thinking, hey, I think you can use user-defined functions because the logic across all of those measures were exactly the same. So over here in the query view, what I'm going to do is say define all the measures in the model. You can see if you look at the logic. So here's for the top three, you know, use the product name, the sales amount, and then the value for the top three. And if you look at the top one, the same thing. And the only thing that varies is the column that they're using to determine the top, the measure, because sometimes he was using quantity instead of sales amount, and the number that he wanted to return in the top three. And I'm like, we can use user-defined functions for that. And so once you have the preview feature enabled, you can create user-defined functions in the DAX query view, in TIMDAL also. And then you can view your functions. If you're in the DAX query view, you choose model, you'll see your function there. I created one function. If you go to TIMDAL, you'll see my function. And if you go to the model view, you can also see the function. And so let's create a sample of this user defined function for you. So went to another window and I'm just going to script one of these out. And now you can see the full measure. So basically I'm creating a virtual table where I'm grabbing the customers and their sales amount. And then I'm getting the top one or top whatever it is I want. And then what I do from here is I use concatenatex to concatenate the list and then I return it. That's all I do. And you can see here's the result for the top one. And so I said, let's change this to a user defined function. So let's do a carriage return here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna call this function. So it's defined function and we're gonna give it a name. We're gonna call it top in items equal. Once you have the function defined, you will specify your parameters and then you will declare the code in your function. Now, parameters are optional. In this case, we want to make this flexible enough. So I'm going to pass a column name, I'm going to pass a measure, and I'm going to pass the number of top items I want to return. And so a lot of people ask me this, hey, Patrick, why do you prefix function names and variable names with underscores? Because I don't want to make sure they don't use keywords. When you create a function, it can't use an existing function name or any existing keywords. Same thing for my parameter name. So this is going to be a measure. And so you give it the name and then colon, and you'll see that I get a list of items here. And these are hints. You don't have to specify any of these hints, but if you want to fully typecast that parameter, you should specify all three, right? There's three, some of them, there's two, depending on what you choose. And so the very first one you can specify is the type. And the four types are anyVal. anyVal can be a table or a scalar. Then there's scalar, then there's a table, and then there's anyRef. anyRef means that you can reference a column, a table, measure, or date. Since this is a measure, I can choose any ref or I can say scalar, and then I can tell it that it's going to be a decimal. And then you have the choice of whether or not it's going to be an expression or a value. And this is your parameter mode. So there's three things that you can specify: the type, the subtype, and the parameter mode. The scalar is my type, the decimal is my subtype, and then the expression or val is my parameter mode. And so value means if I pass the measure in, that measure would be evaluated before I invoke the function, and it's going to be the same same value over and over and over again. And if you're okay with that, that's fine. If I choose the expression is actually evaluated in the function and maybe at a different filter or row context. The documentation is great. I'll be sure to include a link below. In my case, I've specified the scalar and the decimal. If I specify a subtype, I don't need a type. I know it's a lot. You need to go read the documentation. Nevertheless, we'll keep pushing forward. And so I'm going to just choose value. And by default, if you don't specify anything, it will be any val and val. But mine is fully typecast right now. And I'm doing something intentionally incorrect just so you can see what'll happen and we'll go back and fix it. Okay. So my measure, I fully typecast. It's scalar, decimal, and it's a value. The next thing I'm going to specify is my column that I'm going to pass in. And that's going to be any ref because you can pass in a column, a table, a date, or a measure. And so I'll do any ref. And you can see the parameter mode, it can only be an expression. It can't be a value. And it's explicit. So I don't need to specify it, but I will because I'm going to fully typecast everything that I do. And the final thing that I'm going to specify is the top end. And so my top end is just going to be a numeric. I'm ignoring the type because I'm specifying a subtype. And then it's just going to be a value. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in here. I'm going to replace the hard-coded customer, Control Shift L, and I'm going to replace that with underscore column. And then sales amount, I'm going to replace that with measure. And then top end, I'm going to replace that with top end. And then I'm going to make some generic things here. So this is going to be ranking instead of top products. We're going to just call this underscore top item. So now it's a very generic function and I can reuse this over and over again. And now I can update and add this to my model. But before I do that, I want to test this out. So you can see top one customer here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say top one customer UDF. And now you can see my UDF is available. I can use it as a function to execute some things. So the first thing I want to pass is my total sales amount. And then I'm going to pass my customer name and then one. And so it should return the exact same thing that the other one returns. So let's run this. We got a problem. And that's because, remember at the beginning, I said I was going to intentionally do something. That is because I made the parameter mode as value. And now this value is executed once and repeated over and over again in the context of my virtual table. And so I need to change this to expression. And once I change this to expression and run it again, there's lazy. Okay, so you got to be really careful with that. And now all I need to do, if I want to do this for product, I could do the same thing, top one product. And then all I need to do is change this to product name. It's actually pretty cool. And now if I run this, there's my top product. One more, right? So let's say I want to do top two products. Watch this. And I run this and I get my top two products. And I'm not writing all that code. And if I want to change this into a measure, all I need to do is see right below my define for the function, I can do measure. And I can say PBI internet sales, and I can say top two products that equals, and this is the code for my measure, and I'm just using that function. So let's call it top two products UDF. And then we'll copy this and watch. Let's go here and we're gonna do another top two product UDF measure. And then we're gonna paste that there. And when I run this, it returns the exact same thing and with a very little code in my measure. So this is the entire measure as opposed to all the code that I wrote. It's absolutely insane. So if you're repeating logic, if you're doing the exact same thing across multiple measures, you should check out these user defined functions. They're amazing. They can save you so much time. What do you think? Have you used user defined functions? I'd love to know. If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more, check out the video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam, Martha, and this guy, thanks for watching. And we'll see you in the next video.